Hi, I'm Pat Mersky.
And I'm Dan Mersky.
We own Lucy's Riverside Cafe. We've been here in Freeport about 4.5 years. Transplants from Boston area, and we found this beautiful town, Freeport. We had a cafe on Cape Cod, Massachusetts for close to 30 years, and we closed it to come out here and be closer to my family that has moved out here, and also the medical community, that's been helpful for me. Anyways, I wasn't going to do this again. And we came into Freeport, and I saw all the fast food in this area, not in Freeport, but in Western Pennsylvania. And I thought, no, you know what? It's time to have an old-fashioned homemade cooking and just come into my home or come into our home type of place. And I think we accomplished that.
Our main fear is the New England style food, which we brought with us, and everybody seems to really enjoy it. Everything we've done, from soups, salads, sandwiches, paninis, it's just been quite well accepted by everybody.
Yeah, we do the traditional clam chowder that you would find in New England. We used to do our own clamming, and I think I know a little bit about making chowder. I also do, and I say it right, it's chowder. And I also do lobster rolls pretty much about 6 or 7 times a year. And we have quite a list now of people that get on it waiting for the lobster roll. People ask me if I'm Lucy, and I always tell them, Lucy, no. I says, Lucy's our dog, and the story is we named her after Lucille Ball, and we say, why be a Kardashian when you can be a Lucy? And people love that. I always try to make a point of coming out of the kitchen to say hello to everybody, and we have felt such warmth in this community. Freeport is a really pretty little town, and we're trying to bring new business and new people into town.
And they're one of our biggest supporters, the Freeport Renaissance Association, because they believe in small businesses really doing well here in town, and they're number one with our book.
I will say the first couple of weeks I was here, this man came in, and he came right up to me, and he introduced himself as the mayor of Freeport. And I thought that was the neatest thing, that the mayor came in and introduced himself and welcomed us to Freeport. And since then, he's been my number one customer, as well as he has helped increase our business by talking up the small little businesses. And he makes a point of going in and introducing himself and making you feel like you do belong here. The people that live in Freeport, they give you a chance. You know, it is a real small hometown. I would like to see some changes in Freeport as far as the buildings. It needs some help. There's a lot of old buildings. They're beautiful historical buildings with all the architectural detail that need to be restored. We have the Shoot building down on the corner of Market and Fifth. There's a lot of empty storefronts, and I really would like to see them filled. And there's a lot of opportunity here. I always said, if I was 20 years younger, I would have more than one business in Freeport. I would have a bicycle business. I would have an ice cream shop. Yeah, I would have maybe a dry cleaning business. People have to leave now to go to the big superstores like Walmart. And this used to be a town that people never left. There were supermarkets and pharmacies and whatever they needed. And the buses would come in and take the men down to the mill, because most of them worked at Allegheny Loveland years ago. But I would like to see a lot of that come back.
revitalization of the town is very crucial for its existence, which I think it will happen down the road. And the sooner the better.
We believe, and I've always thought when I lived, you know, moved here, this is a town that's gonna come back. I mean, there's no reason for it not to. It's we're like 30 minutes from downtown Pittsburgh, and it's so easy, it's so accessible. And yet you can own a house for under $100,000 in this town and have a little bit of land. This is a great walking community, and you'll see people walking with their dogs and I'm an animal lover, so I love seeing them, but you do. They see walking with their dogs, they're responsible, they pick up after them. There's a lot of kids here. The first parade I ever came to, I was surprised. It was like a flash mob showed up. I couldn't believe where all these people came from all of a sudden. And the parades here, the Memorial Day parade is fabulous. It really is. It's real hometown Norman Rockwell type of living.